No. Okay, we'll start over. Linda, thank you so much for joining us. My voice doesn't usually sound like this. I know you're a patient of Dr. Gwain, so you haven't heard my voice before. But normally I have a really good voice.
Oh, okay. You got a good smile.
I'm good. Thank you. So your knee has hurt for a long time. You wanted to get the shot to help it.
Yes.
And you had a shot for your knee years and years and years ago, 20 years or something?
Yes.
And then lately it's been hurting. And where do you feel it hurting now?
It's basically in the kneecap. And I know, like, if you press in like here or here, and then down here some. You have to find the right spot.
Okay.
In here, you know, it's very tender. Kind of like on this, that's why. Just on this side where it's swollen a little bit.
Okay.
This side, I can touch anywhere, do anything, nothing. It's just.
When did it start hurting like that?
Couple months ago.
Couple months ago. Okay.
And I tried the cream and I tried the medicine, I can't pronounce the name, because my file starts with a D.
Diclofenic?
That sounds like it.
So the joint line is about here, and I'm pushing on it.
Okay.
Does it hurt?
A little bit.
Okay.
If you hit the right area, which you just did.
One of the things I check when I'm doing this is I follow where this muscle would go if it was to continue. It's kind of hard to see. And it's lower than the joint line. And oftentimes people will come in with pain of the joint line, and we'll push on their leg right about here.
Okay, that's okay.
So how did that feel compared to when I was pushing up here on the joint line?
I felt it more down there.
Okay, so that shows me what I was looking for. And that's that you feel this newer pain. It's not the pain of arthritis that's there all the time and usually equal on both legs, although it could be worse in your right because your x-ray does show some arthritis worse in the right leg.
Yeah.
But this pain just lasts through months, few months, and it's making it hard to walk. I'm really thinking it's not the arthritis that's happening acutely right now. There may be some arthritis pain, but that it's because of a bursitis down here that hurts really bad right now. And the best way, the approach that's most likely to get us the most relief for you would be to give you a cortisone shot in this bursa, this bursitis, right over where these tendons attach to the leg, rather than to give you a shot in the joint today. Now, you may benefit from a shot in the joint, but we don't have to do that today. We can see how you recover from this. And my guess is that within a few days' time, you'll be walking much better with a shot here than if we went into the joint for the arthritis.
And again, that's why I'm coming to you, because you're the professional.
We'll find out. I'm not a doctor.
I don't diagnose myself.
Good.
And so,
So we'll find out. So part of the knee exam that we would do is actually pressing around. It was a little tender there. Is it tender in front?
Nope.
And you said something about the kneecap area. This is the kneecap here.
Just, you know, and usually at night, it's on this side of the kneecap, and that's why I put heat, and I've been doing the heat, the ice, the heat,
That's the classic localization of a bursitis from down here.
I this weekend.
Okay. And other things we do is we strain it to the side. And what I'm doing is trying to make it open up over here if it's going to, but you have an intact medial collateral ligament, or MCL, so it's not opening up. You also have an intact LCL on this side. We check the anterior cruciate limit, or the ACL, by pulling like this.
Okay.
Now, you kind of moved there. Is it because you didn't want me to pull you off the table?
Yes, I think safety first at all times.
Good. So I'm not feeling any laxity in the knee there, and I'm also pushing back the PCL, or posterior cruciate ligament, also inside of the center of the knee there, is not giving way at all. There's no looseness, no laxity of the joints.
Are you saying I got a tight leg?
That's right. And then I'm twisting your leg and moving it. And what we're testing for here is a sign that often comes with problems with the meniscus. A meniscus tear will often cause a pain when doing this, and it's not happening. So I recommend that we go ahead and give the shot here. The areas where this muscle would attach, if you could imagine these muscles coming down and the tendons spreading out, it looks almost like a bird's foot, which is why it's called the Pes Anserine. And the way we do it is we go from the center out of the area that we want to have clean. That way, when we do another one that is clean, the area that we're going to be working is the absolute cleanest because we wipe away from it outward. So if we're picking up some dirt and taking it, we're taking it away from where the shot goes. Now this isn't totally sterile. I am using gloves that have touched some things, and that's okay. We still get good results. And this is the cortisone medicine here. I'm just getting it up in the plunger. There it is. And this is the anesthetic. I don't want you looking at the needle.
Okay, that suits me fine, as long as I know what's gonna happen.
Okay, I'm gonna spray some cold stuff on your leg.
Ouch, it is cold.
It's really cold.
It's like freezing cold, that's okay.
It is, it makes you so cold that it doesn't hurt as bad when you get a shot. Now one of the things I'm doing is I'm putting my knees, ooh, that's the spot, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'll give you a shot there, sorry. All right, I'm gonna go back in.
I think you found the tender spot.
Yeah, I really wanna hit a different spot here because okay. I want to know that there's a bone under it. I'm not hitting the bone, I just want to be able to tell that it's there.
Okay.
Because that's where the bursa is.
It just feels like a little numbness or something in my leg.
Mm-hmm.
But absolutely no pain, so that's good.
Okay. Now, the cortisone does not take effect for a couple days, sometimes a little longer. So you won't get the full effect, but for the next 5 hours or so, you will have less pain when you walk. So let me put a Band-Aid on that. Actually, just a little one is all we need. And we'll have you walk.
Hey, now, I appreciate
it. I saw how you walked earlier. And it was not good.
No, it wasn't. And so I want to come in before it got worse.
Now we made two spots. I'm going to have this reach all the way from one to the other. And yeah, let's see how you walk. And I can give you a hand.
Oops. Clumsy me. I'm used to the step drag. Oh, at least I can stand. Oh, I can feel it.
Yeah, try
it. Yes, I can feel it.
Try to relax a little. You're still walking very stilted.
Yeah, my knee just hurts a little bit, not compared to how it was.
And we do know that you do have arthritis in that knee, so that can be part of it.
That could be, but compared to how I was walking and... Yes, because I wasn't sure if I'd be able to drive home afterwards, so I had somebody bring me.
Good, good, good. All right, so we'll expect that this will start hurting again in about 5 hours because the anesthetic wears off.
Okay.
Cortisone will take a few days to kick in, and then you'll love it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So do I continue with the heat and ice, or just...
At this point, you don't have to do either. Because of that bruise, it might be nice to use a little bit of ice for a while, but... it's not seriously going to make much difference in the outcome. Whatever feels comfortable to you.
Okay.
As far as temperature.
I can put my weight on it now.
Yeah.
Because I feel myself standing straight now to where I wasn't, and I was, you know, guarding myself.
We talked about that. Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Okay, good. So we'll just have you do that and let us know in a few days what you think of it. Just give us a call if it's not feeling better.
Okay.
And I thank you so much for joining us. We want to
recognize
some of our friends, BooBoo Kitty and Lindsay Antoine, who helped to make this possible. Thank you. And other people can join on Patreon and see not only our videos here, like everybody can, but even other videos that aren't public. And you can even watch them if you want.
Okay.
Until next time, Linda and Dr. Mark Vaughan telling you to stay in good health. Thanks, Linda. That was fun.
Thank you.